Chapter 28 of Buster Bear's Twins by Thornton W. Burgess. Boxer Gets His Own Breakfast. True independence he has earned, who for himself to do has learned. Mother Bear. It seemed to Boxer, the lost little bear, that that dreadful night would last forever, that it never would end. Of course, it didn't last any longer than a night at that season of the year usually does, and it wasn't dreadful at all. The truth is, it was an unusually fine night, and everybody but Boxer and anxious Mother Bear thought so. Perhaps you can guess just how glad Boxer was to see the jolly little sunbeams chase the black shadows out of the green forest the next morning. He still felt frightened and very, very lonesome, but things looked very different by daylight, and he felt very much braver and bolder. First of all, he took a nap. All night he had been awake, for he had been too frightened to sleep. That nap did him a world of good. When he awoke, he felt quite like another bear. And the first thing he thought of was breakfast. Now, always before, Mother Bear had furnished Boxer with his breakfast and with all his other meals. But there was no Mother Bear to do it this morning, and his stomach was very empty. If anything were to be put in it, he was the one who would have to put it there. Just thinking of breakfast made Boxer hungrier than ever. He couldn't lie still. He must have something to eat, and he must have it soon. He crawled out from under the pile of brush, shook himself, and tried to decide where to go in search of a breakfast. But being lost, of course, he had no idea which way to turn. "I guess it doesn't make much difference," grumbled Boxer. "Whichever way I go, I guess I'll find something to eat if I keep going long enough." So Boxer started out. And because he had something on his mind, something to do, he forgot that he was lonesome, and he forgot to be afraid. He just couldn't think of anything but breakfast. Now, while he never had had to get food for himself before, Boxer had watched Mother Bear getting food, and felt that he knew just how to go about it. He found a thoroughly rotted old stump and pulled it apart. It happened that he found nothing there to eat. But a few minutes later, he forgot all about his disappointment as he pulled over a small log and saw ants scurrying in every direction. He promptly swept them into his mouth with his tongue and smacked his lips at the taste of them. He didn't leave that place until not another ant was to be seen. By and by, he dug out certain tender little roots and ate them. How he knew where to dig for them, he couldn't have told himself. He just knew, that was all. Something inside him prompted him to stop and dig, and he did so. Once he chased a wood mouse into a hole and wasted a lot of time trying to dig him out. But it was exciting and a lot of fun, so he didn't mind much, even when he had to give up. He caught three or four beetles and near the Laughing Brook surprised a young frog. Altogether, he made a very good breakfast. And because he got it all himself, with no help from anyone, he enjoyed it more than any breakfast he could remember. And suddenly he felt quite a person of the great world, and quite equal to taking care of himself. He forgot that he had cried for his mother only the night before. The great world wasn't such a bad place after all. End of Chapter 28.